expansion.
This is a disclaimer. I do not condone the illegal use of stealing phones or others' data. These videos are used for educational purposes and to get the companies to notice the vulnerabilities in their product. Thank you.
Hello, YouTube. Today I'm going to be showing you how to perform a FRP bypass or factory reset bypass on the LG Stylo 4. Once again, if your phone in your hands doesn't look like the one on screen, then you're on the wrong video. If it does, you're in luck. This device has already been factory reset. If you don't know how to factory reset your phone, the video is in the description and on screen. You may reset your phone for a number of reasons. New phone, new you? Seeing how long before people notice you're missing? Well, when you're ready to come back to society, I have the solution. But before we get started, leave a like, comment, follow, share, anything. It all helps. Thanks. Now, back to the good stuff. Before you do anything though, you're gonna need two different phones, the LG Stylo 4 and another phone that works, and a nano SIM card. If you don't know what a nano SIM card is, here's a size comparison on screen for you to follow. I created a password and a Google account lock to increase the security as if it was my normal device. From here, you're gonna wanna put a lock on your SIM card. You don't have to set your own, as long as the PUK code or PUK code locks you out of your phone when the SIM card is in. If you have absolutely no idea what I just said or how that works, I'll be posting a video shortly after this detailing how to do that. Check back soon for that. Once the SIM locks your phone, take the nano SIM card out of your working phone and put it into the LG Stylo 4. The lock should show up on your LG phone now. Take the SIM card back out. Whether your phone screen times out or not, you should still end up on the swipe lock screen. The swipe lock screen is a screen that allows you to see the notifications on your phone without opening it. From here, you'll want to not press, but rather swipe down on the only notification there. And from there, click the capture feature in the top left corner of your quick settings bar. It should take a picture of your screen. On the top of your screen, you should see a red circle with a pen icon in it. Press the text icon right next to it. Accept the pop-up and move on. From here, go back onto the top of the screen and press the three little dots on the rightmost side of your screen. Choose Photos instead of Gallery, and open from the pop-up by pressing just once. Allow Photos to access the permissions on screen. You should now be taken to a photo in Google Photos of the screenshot you just took with Capture. There are two options to the bottom of your screen, Share and Information. Press the Share button on the left side of the screen near the bottom. You'll be given a lot of options to share to. Choose Email on the top right column. Again, allow the email's permissions. At this point, you'll have three options: Microsoft Exchange, Google, and Other. Choose Microsoft Exchange at the top. You're going to want to type the email you know. Only type the email, not the password. Once you have your email typed, you should see an option titled Manual Setup just above your keyboard. Click it. You should be taken to another screen titled Server Settings with your email already pre-typed. From here, just scroll all the way to the bottom until you see Client Certificate. Click the Add button to the right side of the screen from the option previously mentioned. You should get a pop-up on your screen like mine. This step is telling you that you need to create a new password in order to continue. Press the Change option in blue. Now it will take you to the option to set up a new lock screen. Choose the PIN option. It will ask you if you want a secure startup, which means the device will make you input the password before the device fully powers on. At this moment, choose No Thanks. Make sure the PIN password is easy to remember. You'll be using it quite a few times. You'll have to re-input the password to confirm you won't lock yourself out. After confirming your PIN, the phone will ask if you want to set up a fingerprint. Press Next. Retype the password that you just created and press OK. Now it will ask you to place your finger on the sensor of the device. Don't do this part. Now what you want to do is use the only working phone command button. Press the back button. Those are the buttons at the very bottom of your screen. Keep pressing that back button until you are all the way back to the factory screen when you originally factory reset the phone. From this point, go through the setup process for your device as if it was brand new. You will once again meet the dreaded factory reset screen, or FRP screen, asking you to input the password. This is no longer the old password on your device. Remember how we changed the password earlier? That is the password you're going to input here. After some loading, you'll see the option to input your own Google account. In the bottom left corner, there's an option to skip. At this point, any option from here is optional. The fact that you even see the skip option at the bottom of the Google account indicates that you've broken the FRP lock. If you don't see the skip option, rewatch this video, because you messed up somewhere. I will now just show that the account no longer has any accounts attached to it. Alright, if this video helped you or anyone you know, leave a like, comment, share, go check out my Patreon, and get ready for my new series where I'll be covering tech companies and the dark things that happen behind them. Thanks.
Techspansion.